A very good morning, children. In the previous segment, we started studying about Emperor Ashoka. So let's continue with it. So children, Ashoka was a unique ruler. The most famous modern ruler was Ashoka. He was the first ruler who tried to take his message to the people through inscriptions. Most of Ashoka's inscriptions were in Prakrit and were written in Brahmi script. Then talking about Ashoka's war in Kalinga. Kalinga is an ancient name of coastal Orissa. Ashoka fought a war to conquer this place to win his rule over this place Kalinga. However, he was so horrified when he saw the violence and bloodshed that he decided not to fight any more wars. So now when Ashoka was fighting to conquer Kalinga, to us war mein he saw so much violence, so much bloodshed, so many people died, they lost their lives. So after seeing that horrible scenario, he was the first king and the only king in the Indian history who decided that he will give up war and he is not going to indulge in any of the war after that. So he is the only king in the history of the entire world who gave up conquest after winning a war. Then Ashoka's inscriptions that describe the Kalinga war, this is what Ashoka declared in one of his inscription is, 8 years after becoming king, I conquered Kalinga. About 50,000 people were captured and more than 100,000 of people were killed. This filled me with sorrow. Why? Whenever an independent land is conquered, 100,000 of people die and more are taken prisoner. Brahmins and monks also die. People who are kind to their relatives, friends, to their slaves and servants, they also die. They lose their loved ones. That is why I am sad and I decided to observe Dharma and to teach others about it as well. I believe that winning people over through Dharma is much better than conquering them through force. Unhone kya decide kiya? I will conquer the people through love, through non-violence, instead of fighting, instead of forcing them and conquering their state. I am inscribing this message for the future so that my son, my grandson after me should not think about war. Instead, they should try to think about how to spread Dharma. Ashoka's Dharma did not involve worship of a god or a performance of a sacrifice. He felt that just as the father tries to teach his children, he had a duty to instruct his subjects. He was also inspired by teachings of Lord Buddha. There was a number of problems that troubled him. People in the empire followed different religions and this sometimes led to conflicts. Animals were sacrificed, slaves and servants were ill-treated. Besides, there were quarrels in the families and amongst neighbors. But Ashoka felt that it was his duty to solve these problems. So now he appointed officials who were known as Dharma Mahamat, who went from place to place teaching people about Dharma. He wanted everybody to live with peace without fighting. So now he started spreading those teachings to the people through various ways. After this, Ashoka got his messages inscribed. He got it written over the rocks and pillars, instructing his officers to read this message to those who could not read it themselves. Everybody he wanted to learn about this practice of non-violence. Now Ashoka, he also sent messengers to spread ideas about Dharma to other lands such as Syria, Egypt, Greece, Sri Lanka. He built roads, dug wells and built rest houses. Besides this, he made arrangements for medical treatments for both human beings and animals. Then there is Ashoka's message to his subjects, which said that people perform a variety of rituals when they fall ill, when their children get married, when children are born, or when they are on a journey. These rituals are not useful. If instead people observe other practices, this would be more fruitful. Then what could be those other practices? Agar hum rituals nahin karein, toh what could be the other practices? So these are being gentle with your servants, respecting one's elders, treating all creatures with compassion, gifting gifts to Brahmins and monks. It is both wrong to praise one's own religion and to criticize others. Each one should respect the other's religion. If one praises one's own religion while criticizing another's, one is actually doing greater harm to one's all religion. We should not always appreciate what religion we follow and defame the other person's religion. That is very wrong. Therefore, one should try to understand the main ideas of another religion and respect it. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India, wrote, "His instructions still speak to us in a language we can understand and we can still learn much from them." So Ashoka was a great ruler, great emperor who spread the message of non-violence, who spread the message of love, equality and respect among the people for all the fellow human beings. And being a citizen, we all should respect our all fellow beings, rather it is a human being or it is an animal, because everybody has got equal right of living, surviving in this world, and we are nobody to question anybody's survival.